There we go.
Yeah.
Powers of technology. It's a bitch, isn't it?
Listen. Oh my gosh.
Well, we can do this properly. Neila, the beautiful alien. How are you, darling?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm not too bad. I've worked my ass off today, and I was getting prepped and getting my mind in the zone and getting excited to chat to you. So I got some leftover energy for you, babe.
Yes,
yes,
energy.
Yes, yes. I mean, let's start off with, you know, with everything that's been going on for the past couple of months. Everyone knows the deal by now. 2020 has been a really crazy year. I mean, all the way starting back in March, everyone knows the deal. I mean, how have things been for you, and how have you been able to keep mentally stable throughout this time?
Inwardly and personally, everything has been going really, really great. Career-wise, everything has been doing great. Outwardly, you know, obviously it's fucking insane. And some days are tougher than others, but for me, it's affirmations, meditation. Journaling helps me tremendously.
Okay.
Those three things keep me grounded, and then, like, if I do them every day, they help me out, and when I don't do them, you can tell. Everybody around me can tell the difference.
It's like for me, like, if I'm not constantly being proactive, or if there's not anything that I can do at a certain time to keep my mental in check, then I'm thinking, wow, like, I can't be sitting down for too long. Like, I have to be doing something at least. Has that been the way for you?
No, music has literally saved my life this last couple of months, because if I wasn't working on my project, and we weren't shooting visuals, and we weren't shooting acoustic visuals, and we weren't doing all these things, I would not know where the hell my mind would be right now. So I'm super grateful for my management, my team. Like, we've just really been working really freaking hard. So that has kept me productive. And I think me being a Capricorn, being productive is, like, literally how I, like, pat myself on the back. So that's helped me a lot.
Well, I got a little surprise to tell you.
Okay.
I'm a Capricorn myself.
What? That's what I'm talking about.
When's your birthday?
January 17th.
Mine's 25th of December.
Christmas?
Yes. Yes.
Oh my goodness.
8:08 in the afternoon, UK time.
Mine is 10:33 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Right, so you're night baby, and I'm an afternoon baby. Like, I mean, we're gonna get into, like, those sort of stuff later on, but, like, I mean, I've heard that you was a Capricorn when you did an IG live with Monique Laws, who is someone you heavily support as well. So we're gonna get into her a little bit too. But I mean, when it comes to, like, people, because. When I've spoken to artists and about finding out what the star signs are, because I'm a bit of a nerd sometimes when it comes to it, most of the time they don't know Capricorns that well. So then I'm thinking, like, that's a kind of low key disrespect, because I feel personally that we as a sign are just so underrated. Like, do you feel that that's the case for you, or do you feel like a lot of people know you and your traits?
First, I feel like nobody really knows me, because I don't tell people shit.
Okay, that's a good idea, I guess, if you want to keep private, like, proper.
But Capricorn-wise, like, the only thing people say is that we're stubborn. Like, people don't really know that, like, Capricorns are, one, like, loyal as hell. Like, super loyal.
100%.
Like, 90% of the time, if we say something to you, is because that's exactly what we're thinking and how we mean.
Yep, exactly,
like,
that.
Mean. So
yep,
it's like,
we don't hide the bullshit.
We're very straightforward. We're goal, no bullshit, goal oriented. And, like, if we like you, you know. And if we don't like you, you also know. So it's like, what you see is what you get. Like, you don't have to question and wonder with a Capricorn, because we will let you know and you will feel it if we don't verbally tell you. And I think that we don't get enough cred for being the loyalist zodiac sign. Like, we are loyal. Like, if you are our family, if we consider you friends, like, we will go ride for you. And I think that gets overlooked. But we make money, too. So, like, we're like money.
Hey, listen, I'm about saving my money. I'm about making sure that I don't necessarily have to be spending on the most amount, like, you know, to save expenses. But for me, it's more security. Like, I like to know I'm secure when I'm about my paper, you know?
Right. Yep. I feel you.
we all there. So I'm glad to know that, you know, I've got a fellow Capricorn that fully understands how this shit runs, man, and how we are loyal to a fault.
Yep.
You know, the ones there. So obviously, like, you know, during this time as well, like, you know, I've seen that you've been creative during this time, but I know that it probably has been difficult with a lot of clubs and festivals and music venues being shut down. Like, has it been difficult for you as an artist, like, apart from making tracks? Has there been, like, other avenues you've been able to take during the process of lockdown? Like, you know, what's the process there for you?
So I 150,000,000% miss performing live. Like, the energy, the feeling, the nervousness before, and then the excitement after, like, I miss that so much. It's not even funny. But I have done other, like, you know, festivals, like, online, like, you know, how they've been doing, like, fish festival streams and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But a lot of things that my management and I were planning has been, like, you know, postponed, and we're still doing them, but we had some really dope ideas with the project that we were planning on doing starting back in April that we kind of had to push back. So I'm still excited to do that, and we're still going to do it, you know, 2021.
I was going to ask you, like, if 2021, God bless, hopefully that, you know, things kind of semi more return to normal, nightclubs open, venues open a little bit more. I mean, obviously, with now the social distancing to be in place, hopefully that you'd be able to, you know, travel a lot more and just, you know, I mean, see the fans that support you.
Yes, I 100% cannot wait. I can't wait to come to London. I can't wait. I have a lot of fans in Brazil.
Oh, wow.
I've actually learned some Portuguese, like, yo, tudo bem. Like, I think that means, like, hi, how are you?
Okay.
Because they, like, send me, like, voice messages and stuff on Instagram all the time.
So you're trying to figure out, what did they say?
Yeah, so like they speak, like, English, but, like, I asked them questions, like, oh, right, how do I say this so I can, like, you know, talk to you. But yeah, I definitely want to travel and festivals. Like, that's been on my list to do, like, all these fucking amazing festivals for years. And I feel like I finally have a team to where, like, we can, like, dominate, and I have, like, an amazing manager and a fucking amazing publicist, photographer, videographer, makeup artist. Like, I have a great team. So I'm finally in the space to where, like, we can do this. And we were doing it, and then COVID.
I mean,
but it's okay.
Yeah, I mean, plans can be made during this time as well. Like, there are other things that you can compensate, and by the time it all comes around, then it'll be executed, hopefully, you know what I mean? So, I mean, have you ever come to our side yet?
I have never been across the pond.
Okay. Well, first of all I'll say is this. If ever we cross paths, like, actually physically meet, then I can be your personal tour guide. So that can be set in stone there. So I can help you out for that. And, I mean, what have there been things about London that you're excited of the prospect of in terms of if you come over?
I have friends that are actually from London.
Okay.
And, like, we always, yeah, so, like, and my publicist is also from London, so yeah.
We got Sophie.
I have friends that, yes, Sophie, but we link in, like, LA and Miami and in Atlanta, everywhere but London. So I think it'd be super cool for me to, like, be, like, where they are, because I'm from Florida. So one of my really, really good friends, Damson Idris, he's an actor, and he's from London, and he always comes to, like, Florida, and, like, it's where I'm from, you know what I mean? So I would love to be, like, where my friends are from. And, like, just the, first of all, the women in London, oh my God.
I mean, you know, we got our beautiful ladies over here, but then I can say the same for y'all over there too. I mean, you're definitely the beautiful alien for a reason, man.
Oh, thank you. But I just want to be around some bad girl, like, women. Like, they dress and their hair. And, like, I'm just like, yes, I'm ready to go over there and, like, go shopping and just the music scene. And it'd be dope. And Sophie, she's really, like, plugged in, too. So I think it would be super dope to, like, finally be, like, you know, in her space. Because she's always in mine. So I think it'd be cool.
Well, I mean, I can't wait for that to be the prospect. So let's get you over here, man. Let's get this COVID shit out of the way, man. So let's get into it properly then. So I found out your name is actually spelt backwards. So it's actually alien spelt backwards. So Neila is alien. So what made you think of that as a concept? Did you think of yourself that you're always like someone unique in their approaches? Is that... Because I heard as well that your brother used to tease you, that call you an alien stuff. And how did that come?
So evil. But I grew up in a family that's super, like, spiritual. And my dad was always into, like, watching, like, ghost adventures and ancient aliens, a lot of stuff like that. So I kind of grew up, like, in that space of already... having the knowledge that there's something else outside of me and what we know as like our reality. And as I got older and my brother picked on me and I'm just like, I am an alien because I'm nothing like you guys.
did you think at that moment? Did you think at that moment because the fact that your brother was just doing that to you? And then all of a sudden you said, you know what? I'm not going to let it get the best of me. So you know what? I'll come up with a quick bang to you and say, like, you know what, I am, so fuck off, I got my alien status right here,
literally. And I started doing YouTube videos, and I had a different name at the time, and I started doing YouTube videos and I'm like, hi, da 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 da, and I'd be like this little
what was your YouTube name at the time then?
Oh, I cannot tell you. Oh, it's embarrassing. And it's my real name. I don't want to know my real name yet. After this.
Okay. Can you at least give me a clue in terms of the first letter of your first name, at least?
It's so boring. It's like the most, think of like the most regular, and like no offense to anybody else has his name, but like, come on, like our parents didn't try that hard. So regular, simple, American name for a girl.
Okay, all right. I'll do a little digging and see if I could come up with it, and then I'll DM you and see. And, I mean, put your comments down below and let us know if you figured out the name, and then see if you're right or not.
So simple. Somebody's gonna guess it because it's like literally the most simplistic.
Okay.
Completely opposite from who I am.
Okay. Fair enough. I think it might be more easier to take that in. So, I know the most notable thing about you is your hair. And I know that you've had green hair for ages, and I don't know if you noticed, I thought I'd just go with the theme as well. I'll go with the whole theme of green, because I know that's the alien vibes, and I'm with that. what got you to the point of that you wanted to have your hair specifically green, and were your parents always supportive of the idea when you did do it, or were they like, what the fuck are you doing?
So I just felt, I have like dark brown natural hair, and I thought I was like so boring. I was like, oh man, I need something. And my favorite color is actually pink. So that is where I was going at first. And then my mom actually took me to the hairdresser. And so my parents are like super supportive. So they kind of just let me be me, which is great. But she looked at me, she's like, are you sure you want to do pink? And I'm like, you're right, mom. Pink is too fucking regular. I'm gonna do green. She was like, green? Yes.
So your mom was on it. She was with you for the whole thing. She was like, yeah, do what you want, babe.
Yeah. I think growing up with me and just realizing, like, my parents are super cool about, like, understanding each of their children.
Right.
And they were just like, yeah, she's different, so we're gonna let her, and I'm the only girl, so she's like, we're gonna let her do her thing. So my mom, I was just like, last minute, I was like green, and went to, like, I'm Jamaican and Bajan, my mom's from Barbados, but I'm from Jamaica, so went to, like, you know, in South Florida, we have like these like all the hairdressers we go to are like Jamaican. So like my Jamaican hairdresser is like looking at me like, where the hell am I about to find green hair dye? And she ended up finding some green hair dye.
Hey, but I know with a lot of Jamaican parties, like, you know, with like hairdos and outfits, you know what I mean? We wild out here when it comes to it. I've seen parties myself like that.
Yeah, no, Jamaicans, we are loud for sure. Mm. But this is like an older Jamaican lady that like does hair. So, you know, it's like she's just doing like the perms and like the roller set. And I'm over here like, yeah, I want green hair. And she's like,
she must have been like, "What did Bomba Clat y'all doing?"
I'm pretty sure my dad said some shit like that when I came to the house.
Yes.
Yeah, I ended up doing green. I ended up doing green, and it's like, it's insane because I did green, and it was a little bit darker at the time. And then literally like 2 weeks later, Kylie Jenner had that green wig that she did. And then everyone was green. And I was just like, did I pick the wrong fucking color?
Or you could look at it, or you could look at it as to say you started a trend.
Shit. I mean, I don't want to say I started it, you know, because there was Khalees and like Nicki Minaj. They had their colors and I want to pay respect.
Okay, say at the modern time then.
Right. But I definitely was doing it because no one else was doing it at the time, and I thought it was like, okay, this is different, like this is gonna be some different shit. And green became like a trend for a little second. You know, I was a little salty and a little salt tears, but I cannot imagine myself with like red color hair.
Well, I mean, this defines you, and I love the fact that you were willing to go beyond what's considered normal and going that is your personality, that you're bringing it to the table. You're not faking yourself because of it. It's an added addition to your personality. So I appreciate that you just went beyond what you thought was normal. I just wanted to ask as well, like, you know, back to the alien stuff for a minute. Would there be if there was a feature from an alien that you might have seen, what feature would you like to take from the alien and claim it to be yours?
Like a physical feature?
Yes.
Or like, okay. I kind of like how like alien eyes are like this.
Okay. What, like googly eyes?
But like, they're kind of like, you know how like cat eyes are like slanted?
Yes.
I like how alien eyes, like, well, the cartoon idea of what an alien is.
Yeah.
So we can go down like a whole rabbit hole with like humanoids and like a whole bunch of things, but but the idea, I kind of like those like big, like, you know.
Okay.
Eyes, kind of like go up to like your temples.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So
I would never actually do that to myself, but like, you know, if I had a pick, I like that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's like a physical attribute.
Yeah. I mean, do it to a point where you're not like, you know, putting your eyes out and then starting to scare everyone with that shit. But as long as like it's sexy and it comes across and it's big and, you know what I mean? I dig that. I dig that. And
so then my makeup artist, like, she'll do my like makeup looks to where it kind of like does that. So it kind of like looks like my eyes. Like that.
Yeah. But then I was thinking like, you know, where would you get glasses from unless you get like, you know, comedy props or something like that? Because I don't know if there would be glasses that would be of that size that can make it, you know, stylish. I don't know. I might be wrong.
I wear glasses now and no one knows I wear glasses because I wear contacts 24/7. So
yeah,
I don't know about that.
Well, I mean, you're styling girl with that one. I mean, okay, so let's take it back for our audience a little bit. So for those to get to know you, I mean, a lot of artists I've spoken with, especially during these remote interviews, they've had like a rapping or singing background from a young age or during school days. Was it like that for you in terms of that? Like, when did you realize that music would be your path in life?
And entertainment in general was always in my life. I did ballet for like 13 years and I was with a company called Jubilee. Mm. And during that same time, I also was classically trained vocally. I was always kind of like a serious kid, mm. Capricorn trait.
Yep.
So I always knew what I wanted to do from like the moment that I knew that singing existed. And I always wanted, if you like go back in my parents' house and my back home, I had like literal affirmations that at the time I didn't know that that's what I was doing, mm. but I was already doing that. And they're just all about music. My whole entire life has been revolved around my career. career.
Okay. So what was it like in the family household then? Like, was there specific like tracks that your parents or your brothers or sisters were listening to that kind of got you on a nudge of thinking, okay, I might not be singing now, but it's like, I'm interested in, you know what I mean, these flavors. Like, talk to me about, you know, what your family members were listening to in the house that got you intrigued.
I've been singing literally since I can remember. So it was always like, my older brother always like, didn't push, but really wanted me to get into Aaliyah when I was younger. And she passed away when I was like in first grade.
And wow, imagine.
I had a sleepover that day and everything. Like, I remember it so vividly. And so my older brother, who was 4 years older than me, he really wanted me to listen to Aaliyah. And like, you know, so I really got into that. And my parents, when they came to the United States, they lived in New York. And they went to high school in New York, in Mount Vernon High, in New York. So they brought to me, like, you know, my mom's super Michael Jackson fan, so I listened to Michael Jackson a lot. And then in middle school, I had my own Michael Jackson phase that like ran into like my Beatles phase, because I discovered Michael Jackson, you know, Beatles through Michael Jackson, Say with Michael. And so I kind of like ran into like a Beatles phase, and my dad also was a big like classic rock fan too. So I just Kendricks and Beatles. Yeah, and my dad plays drums. My older brother also plays the drums. So my dad would play certain songs, and like I would sing to them like playing on the drums. But a lot of Whitney Houston. Oh my God, we used to I used to be in my parents' room just. He's like, that was the wrong note.
get back, like, girl. So, we're gonna do this shit again.
Yeah, like, let's do that one more time. That wasn't it. Maxwell.
I love Maxwell. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanna get to know ya.
One of my that, I remember as a kid, I literally just did that over and 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 over again. So my mom was just like, try again tomorrow.
Wow. So, because I was going to ask about your mom, because I've, you know, went a little digging and I found out that she's an army veteran. So did that help in terms of...
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's crazy. Oh. I don't know when... I said that, but that's great.
Well, you know what I say, I do the digs around here. So did that help in terms of you being disciplined, in terms of not only like singing but just going towards your goals in general?
You know what's insane, like, my mom was in the military, but she is not strict, which is so funny. I think my parents have a level of strictness to them in general because they're Caribbean, and I come from a very like goal-oriented background, and I know my parents have spoken about, like, you know, how they built their lives for themselves in America. So I'm like, if my parents came from another country and did all of this, like, I live here, like, I should be able to, you know, get my head in. So my dad was the strict one. Yeah.
Okay.
My mom was like, you know, like, when parents play like the bad guy, like bad cop, good cop. My mom was the good cop, and my dad
was a bad cop. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Did you ever get licks if you stepped out of line? Did you get like the belt or slippers or anything like that?
I'm Jamaican and Bajan. Of course I got my ass beat. They beat my ass. And then when they stopped beating my ass, my dad grounded me for everything. I was grounded for breathing too hard. Like, if I chucked my mouth at him, God forbid, me kissing my teeth. Oh my Lord, I got my ass beat. I was grounded for everything. And then like my brothers, I felt like they were never grounded. Like, I swear, I asked my brother to get their ass beat like once each.
So it seemed like your brothers had preferential treatment kind of vibes, and you're the one that's just like, if you stepped out of line, you get the beats, and the brothers that go scot-free.
But I was the rebel, and I was like the talk back person
I'm kind of like that too.
I was a girl.
Yeah.
I felt like because I was a girl, like, my dad kind of like tried to make me different from the boys, and I was like, No,
honey.
Yeah, I talked back, and if he told me no, I still did it. So I just got my ass beat.
Hey, listen, I remember I spoke back to my mom once, and I think this was like years ago. I think it was at a party. I think it was like a house party or something like that. Like, my mom had set up, and I must have said something to her, and literally she took the slipper and slapped me around the head, like, straight. And I never did it since. And it's mad because, like, you say that you're Jamaican and Bajan, and it's interesting because, like, my mum is white British and my dad is Caribbean, but yet my dad was never in the picture. Hence why I do a podcast alongside this, where I talk about all that sort of stuff, all the things I miss, and you know what I mean. And I don't even know what part of the Caribbean I'm from. So this is like a learning curve for me. So what I wanted to ask you about your Jamaican and Bajan roots, do you take any specific parts from those cultures that apply to you in your current everyday life?
I feel like who I am in general, because my parents, I'm first generation American. So right. Because my parents came from other islands, like the only culture they knew were their own. Mm. So that's kind of how I was raised. And when I first started out school, I was in a Caribbean private school,
right,
in South Florida. So even like my beginnings in like academics was Caribbean taught and based. And I think that's why like I was just a stickler of getting good grades, because if you didn't get good grades, like in a Caribbean school, you got hit with a ruler. Mm. So,
old school days. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, I think everything about me, like even when I'm playing with my friends or like I get upset and like I start speaking, I'm like, shit, where the fuck did this came from? And it's like, yeah. But I think everything, the food I eat, honestly, I didn't really eat American food like that, because in South Florida, where I'm from, there's so many different cultures. So I grew up in a part of Florida where like everybody is like immigrants pretty much. So I was able to have like Spanish food, Trinidadian food. My best friend is Trinidadian. I have another friend, really good friend, is Puerto Rican. Like I grew up around so many different cultures. Mm. So like, of course, pizza and stuff, but I was never like a burger person. Like I didn't become like a burger and like hot dog eater.
Right. Like, okay. Really the stereotypical American style of what's considered right. best food.
Right. I never really ate that kind of stuff. Even wings. Like if it wasn't jerk chicken, I wasn't really eating wings. So like I didn't really start doing that until like I moved outside of my parents' home. So I was like, I'm American, you know, but I was raised with such a strong Caribbean background because everybody in my family has an accent.
I can imagine. I mean, what you said in terms of food, like over here in London, there's two specific areas that I can think off the top of my head. So it's an area called Elephant and Castle, which is in South London. And that's a very hardcore Latino community. And they have like a lot of those restaurants across there. It's not massive, but you know it's there as soon as you get there. And I used to get a Colombian barber that used to do my hair, but he moved over to another part of London. So you definitely need to go there. And then in central London, there is a place called Mr. Jerk, but I think they changed it. I think it's to Janet's or something like that. It's basically in central London, and it's a family-run Caribbean restaurant as well. So you definitely need to go there if you ever come on our side as well.
It's called Miss Janet's.
I think it's. I need. I'll DM you. Yeah, I'll DM.
Name by itself, Miss Janet. Yeah.
No, I'll Yeah, no, I don't think it is that, but I will DM you and let you know the restaurant for sure. But yeah, there's definitely some culture over here, and obviously Nando's. Everyone talks about Nando's from our side. Have you ever had a Nando's?
Never. I think I've never been to London, so I think it's only like a London thing because I've never had.
No, but I remember I spoke to Peter Rosenberg via my presenter at the time. This was like 5 years ago, and he said that there was actually one in Maryland.
Oh, yeah, no.
Yeah.
Never been there.
So, I mean, definitely Nando's is one of those institutions that, you know, I mean, if you come to London, it's a given. You have to try it. So they do like jerk. Well, I wouldn't say jerk chicken, but they like, what's this like flame grilled chicken, wings, and you know, halloumi, things like that. So you definitely would enjoy that on our side, man, for sure. So to your music then, so your videos, you definitely take a different spin on them. That let's be real now. And it's colorful, it's vibrant. I mean, some of them as well, like Comfy in particular, when I watched that, it almost gave me like an eerie sort of vibe to it, where you had like the family, but it didn't seem like the typical family in terms of the visuals. Like, but your audio is banging as well, like in terms of like everything. It's so different to what we normally see with artists that come into the scene. How conscious are you when it is to create music to give the audience a feel of something that's not predictable?
Say that one more time. You're breaking up a little bit.
Can you hear okay. me? Yeah. Yeah, I can. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So I was saying, when it comes to your music, like, you're very much someone that takes things out of the box, and you're very, like, colourful in terms of your approach. I mean, when I saw Comfy, there was I had a sense of, like, a little eeriness to it, where it didn't seem like it was, like, a predictable sort of family environment to that. How conscious are you when it comes to creating music to give the audience a vibe of something not to expect, basically?
I don't think I'm, like, super conscious of it. I think it kind of just is who I am.
Yeah.
I don't really think about, like, oh, I gotta make this song different or make this visual different. Like, I've always liked the idea of doing, like, alien, like, weird-ass visuals. So, I've lived my best life, like, when I'm, like, just being weird. Mm. As far as, like, music-wise, like, I'm a writer, so when a beat or instruments speak to me, I kind of just go that way. But I also work completely from scratch. So whenever I'm working with a producer, I'm working from scratch, and I have, like, a producer team. I work with Spree Wilson and this other amazing producer named Jeron, and they just get me to, like, quirky and, like, kind of, like, similar to me in certain ways. So I don't know, like, I like weird sounds. Like, so I kind of just do what I like, you know what I mean? I kind of just do what I like and then go from there. And then visually, like, I like weird shit. Like, I like things that make you think. So,
I think there was, like, Kanye West and Jay-Z song, and they took a quote from, like, Will Ferrell. It's provocative.
Yes. I like making you feel something, even if it's just feeling uncomfortable.
So you're giving it. You want to intentionally give something of an emotion, even if it's not intended to be that. You know, you're giving something for us to think about.
Yeah, and I want to take away the stigmas of what people consider to be, like, sexy as well, because when you think of an alien, you're not like, oh my god, this is, like, a sexy thing. And then it's just like, oh wait, this is a girl with four arms and she's wearing a fucking lingerie, like, what are we doing here?
I mean, you probably would have a lot more fun if you had four arms, in terms of, like, there's some sexy shit going on, but yeah. But I hear what you're saying.
I posted, and there was a moment in my career where I literally posted, like, every picture I had, like, four arms. But but that's fun for me. Like, that's, like, the best times, like, when I'm, like, creating those images and, like, doing that kind of shit. Like, that's fun for me. So outside of it being, like, weird for everybody else, like, it's pretty normal for me and my team. Like, I can literally ask my makeup artist, like, hey, I want to be blue. And she's like, okay, fine, bitch. So my team, and they just know I'm weird. And, like, I always have, like, ideas and stuff running through my mind. So when I'm like, hey, I have an idea, they're like, what's the idea? So I definitely push people to their limits, crazy.
Well, I'd say that weird is wonderful, you know? And a lot of people say that about me, but I just considered myself to be wonderful in that respect anyway. So whether you think I'm weird, I just say it's wonderful.
Yeah, weird is a compliment for me. I'm like, yay, cool, thanks. Like, you know, it really doesn't bother me, like, at all. And I've just always felt different from, like, my peers, even growing up. One, because I was so damn serious, and I knew what I wanted from when I was, like, five. So even from there, it's just, you know, different. My mindset is different. I'm a very goal-oriented person, so focusing on that. But, like, my fun comes when I create, and when I'm able to do, like, all the crazy weird alien shit without people, like, trying to, you know, minimize it or tell me that it's too much
or try and filter whatever, it, like, yeah,
filter it. And for a little bit, that's what I felt like was happening. And I'm really grateful to have a team of people who, like, really believe in who I am and, like, don't want to, like, you know, put it through a filter.
Well, I mean, speaking of stuff that you like to have fun in terms of music, you got your new single, Nasty. And there was a line that really caught my eye, caught my ears more like, When you said eeny, meeny, miny, mo, if that man don't lick no more, take him to the doctor. There's a problem. He needs help for sure. So, I guess we're suggesting that if he doesn't eat from the kitty box, then he's out the door, I guess.
Yeah. Honestly, when I was... I have a journal that I keep things in. So when I was writing back and I was like looking through my journal, right, and I had like a little piece in there, I was talking about like someone in that situation. And yeah, it was just like, I remember writing my journal, like, what's wrong with him? And so when I was writing the song, yeah, it kind of like the any mini mighty mo part came first. And then, you know, it's just like, as women, I feel like we limit our pleasure because in our minds, it's like, oh, like, I don't know. It sometimes it feels like we're like having to pleasure our partners. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, what about me? Like, what about me? Hello. So,
I think I think there's been like a stigma attached to it, like, because I remember back in the day, like, I would be talking to some of my friends about it, and, you know, I mean, I'll be honest, you know, I've had a few share of kitty boxes, you know, in my time, not regularly. I'm not trying to say I'm a man whore. I'm putting it out there right now. You know what I mean? I'm not like that, but I'm saying the encounters I've had a taste of the kitty box. And then when I speak to some of my friends about it, they're just like, you're fucking mad. I ain't touching the box. Are you stupid, fam? I'm like, well, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with, if you're receiving, why don't you just give back? As long as you know in your head, if you know that she's all right, clean, everything's nice, and you know that's the case, then what's the problem?
First of all, I want to say that health is super, super important.
Of course.
So, you know, before any of that, both ways, though, anything of that, like, you know, happens, you should definitely, like, you know, respect yourself enough and the other person as well, just to make sure that y'all are good, you know what I mean?
100%.
So, safe sex.
Yes.
But what's not about to happen is if you think that I'm gonna just, you know, do you a favor, you're not gonna do me a favor, like, that's it's like, it's like this like weird, like, I feel like women give so much, like, sexually, emotionally, all this type of stuff, and then like men just like, hey girl, I'm gonna just stick this in you.
I think it's a way. I can't speak for all men. I can only give my perception of what I think the problem might be in terms of that, is that we as men look at eating the box as to say that we are downplaying ourselves as men, meaning that we're not strong like that. So for me to go and box now, it's like I'm, how can I put it? It's like I'm submitting, so to say. So, like, you know, you know, we feel that women being submissive to us in that respect, it not, no disrespect intended, but it's like we're not going to be submissive because we don't want to downplay ourselves as men. Again, I'm just putting my perception of what I feel the problem is. But to say I have tried, so.
Well, I'm good for you.
Thank you. I feel like I'm going to be looking back on this. I'm thinking like, did I admit all this shit? But hey, listen, it's fine. No one gets hurt. It's fine. But I mean, the track's banging anyway. Like, it gives me that 808 feel. Like, you know, I could bust it out in the car. You know what I mean? It's definitely sounds like it's playable in the clubs. Like, people could just twerk to it and dance to it. And it just seems that everyone just go in and have a good time. I can definitely feel that. Like, when I was hearing it earlier, it's just like my headphones were about to, oh shit. You know what I mean? Cause yes, it was
spraying around with the production. They really like went crazy on this project.
Nah, definitely. And based on that, because obviously, you know, you made the track nasty, I was curious, have you got any fetishes? I can't even say the word, fetishes.
I don't.
Mm.
Yeah, I feel like people expect me to be like, I'm weird creatively, but people, like, I think they expect me to be like, yeah, like, you know, take acid and whatever. And I'm like pretty chill and simple. You know, I do dabble in shrooms because, you know, I feel like I'm opening my mind spiritually, but I take them like on a spiritual basis. So like I'll take them if I'm meditating, if I'm like planning out like a spiritual day. But I'm really not that crazy. I love you, hold my hand.
Yeah, so you're more like, you know, passionate in terms of like, you know, in terms of like, you know, the hugs, kisses, stuff like that. I seen in an interview that you did say that you like your butt being rubbed by a guy when you're sleeping.
Yes, I mean, I think that's normal though. Like,
I'm that guy. I listen, like, you know, if it comes to it, like, you know, I'll be happy to just sleep my head on your ass. Like, I'm good. I'll do that. If it's cushiony, which I believe it is, I'll sleep there. It's fine.
Yeah, that's like, you know, like when you're going through like, you know, your woman's thing, like it's cute, like when your man like rubs your tummy and then holds you and you're like, oh, I'm cramping, and he's like, oh, you rub your butt.
I kind of like that as well. I mean, I'm quite a passionate guy, especially like, you know, with us Capricorns, again, I could say that we have like a resting bitch face, but best believe, like, when we are in love with you or when we have an encounter with you, we give our all to it. Do you know what I mean? We love to be passionate. We love to have our hugs and kisses and shit. Don't believe that because we're having a resting bitch phase and we ain't got no emotions. We love that shit. We're just being...
No, like 100%.
You know?
No, yeah. I agree 100%. When I care about somebody, I'm like such like a ball of goo. I'm just like, okay, I love you. But I'm also nobody's punk. So,
well, you know, nobody's love, bitch.
But I'm also like, you don't come over here with that bullshit because you can get cut off real quick.
Straight up, don't fuck around with us. That's all I say. And like I was saying earlier, you're definitely one for supporting women. You know, women enjoy it. You're definitely one that like empowers women. Like I said, I remember earlier when you did IG Live with Monique Laws, someone that you support from our homegrown over here. I mean, of course, like you know, I seen that you both got introduced from the same publicist and you got to connect. So when I saw that, it, the connection, I could see like you ladies fucks with each other. I could see that from the get go. The chemistry was already there. I mean, firstly, like, you know, how do you rate Monique Laws' success so far? But also, you know, who else artist wise are you feeling from like the US and the UK, even on our side?
Well, Monique is literally such a beautiful person. Like, you know, when you can just like feel somebody's just like radiating like love energy, like she's such a beautiful individual. She has been so supportive of me and vice versa. She's such an amazing artist. She's fucking hilarious. Like, she's such a beautiful person. So the moment that when we do make a song together, I know it's going to be a fucking hit. I just literally can't wait.
Definitely.
And I can't wait to, and we've never met in real life, so like I literally cannot wait to like actually be like, oh my god,
embrace,
so much love.
yeah
no, she's so like, there's, I feel like right now we're in a space where like you don't meet that many genuine people, and she is so beautifully genuine, so I definitely appreciate her support and just her being a real ass bitch.
Real ass bitch for sure. And you know, who else are you feeling from the US and the UK, like, you know, like female and even male wise?
New artists or like just in general? You know, I mean, as an artist, I feel like you always have those people that you kind of like grew up wanting to work with, and unfortunately a lot of mine have passed away. So, but Frank Ocean is somebody that, if you know me in any sense or form, you know that I'm like the biggest Frank Ocean fan.
A lot of artists I've been speaking with, they do always mention Frank Ocean because he's one of those artists that doesn't show himself to the forefront, but you know his music's banging.
He's amazing. Like, you can listen to a Frank Ocean song fucking a decade later and it still is as amazing, and you're always finding something new when you listen to his music. Like, I feel like as artists, if you're able to, you know, give knowledge from your experiences, that's what's the point of making music. Like, it's not, you know, it's an outlet for us, but it's also people who are listening, they're digesting what we're giving out. If you're giving out rubbish and hate and, you know, sadness or whatever the case may be, like, that's what your friends and people who listen to you are going to digest. So you can give out, like, different bits of just healing throughout your music. I think that's, like, the purpose of being an artist. And I feel like Frank Ocean does that so flawlessly.
Well, big up to Frank Ocean. Have you heard any of our UK talent on our side?
I have heard some, because Sophie, she be playing me shit. I'm like, who is this? And I was actually, DJ Ace played one of my songs, I played Nasty on earlier this week, and I was listening to his, I was like, yay! I'm listening to his mix, and I'm like, yo, these UK artists are freaking bomb.
Was there any names that stood out that you heard about? You thought, oh,
I
shit.
I honestly don't remember the names, but like just vocally, like I was like, oh, they're giving. They're doing a lot more than we are over here. They're giving. Like vocally was amazing. Literally amazing.
Yeah. Like, wow. I mean, like I said, you know, let's start off with Monique Laws when you come over, and then I would guarantee there will be a lot more artists that you're hearing about over time. I think, like, I want to work with them. Have you heard of Miss Banks?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, and I mean, she's definitely another dope artist that I've had the pleasure to, you know, meet over the years, and you know, I've seen her progression from like 6 years ago, and she just. She went all woman. She was always woman, but she turned all woman.
She's literally so freaking beautiful. And I love, like, the drill, like, women's rap scene over there, too. Like, there's so many women that are doing drill, and I think that's so dope.
I think Shabo comes to mind when I think of drill on the female side. There's a couple of other female drill artists. There's not that many, but, yeah, Shabo definitely comes to mind when I hear that. So that's definitely a person you need to hear on the drill side for females.
Yeah, Twitter also puts me on. I've been put on a lot by Twitter. Oh my God, there's another artist and she is so freaking fire. Oh my God, I'm so sad that I'm blanking because she is so fire. She's an R&B artist, but she can like rap too. She's beautiful. Oh my God, I'm so mad I'm blanking.
Oh, I'm trying to, is she UK based?
Yes.
Right.
And she is fucking insane, like,
Does she have short hair?
She doesn't. Oh man.
I think we'll definitely figure out who that is. We'll go on the DMs for that for sure. So it's a good thing. It's a good thing you haven't said completely and a full description, and then it's just like, oh gosh, is that what you think of me? But we don't even know. So you know, it's all good. It's all good. I mean, I wanted to get your thoughts for a second, just the, you know, to be serious for a minute. Because I know that you're a strong, powerful black woman. And, of course, everything going on, you know, the past couple of months, you know, with the protests going on, the killing of George Floyd that started all this off. And, of course, like, you know, we're still seeing a lot of police brutalities. I saw one this afternoon that was disgusting beyond measure. And it's still a continuous thing. And, but I know there has been some changes in terms of we're having conversations, but what do you think needs to happen going forward that we need to do to gain full equality, but also to stop all this madness, really?
There, politically, we need these politicians to stop bullshitting with us and stop having all these empty ass promises when they're going into office.
Agreed.
And so that's one. And then as a community, I feel like it's a lot of growing. People always talk about how, not people, but I've heard there've been things that have been said about like, oh, like, you know, slavery happened so and so long time, like this long ago, like you are blind to not see how still from that things have trickled down in our community, and there's so much inner healing that we have to do as a community. But you know, for that, everyone has to be on the same page, and it starts with you know, a few of us, and it spreads out and it spreads out and it spreads out. But there needs to be some deep healing and unconditioning. Mm. Need to relearn a lot of shit. Because as a community, you know, we have taken in so much hardship from the outside and then kind of have circulated it within our community, and we need to let that shit out and like heal. But I'm so proud of everybody that's been like marching and standing up and using their voice. Because if they didn't hear us before, they fucking hear us now, for sure.
I mean, it's actually televised now, and obviously, like I was saying, countless amount of times, the artists I've been speaking with, even some of my friends, it's education. I think that's most key to start first, even with our children. You know what I mean? Future children, you know, they need that. So at least, like, even if they go about their own merry way when they grow older, at least they got the starting point of what should be taught, really.
Right.
Yeah.
And I think it's super cool. My older brother, I have a nephew, and he's my uncle that has a son. And from a very young age, like, I remember when he first started talking, like, my brother would be like, "You're a black king." And he'd be like, "I'm a black king." And to this day, he's three now. And to this day, my brother would be like, "What are you?" He's like, "I'm a black king." So I think it's definitely starts. Yeah. And, you know, it definitely starts with, you know, teaching the youth and, you know, to have that confidence and to not let anybody take that away from you, because we are a beautiful people.
Mm, definitely, definitely.
An unstoppable, strong people. And this world would never be the same without us. So they need to get that.
Yeah, and we kick ass anyway. So, you know, we need to continue that going forward and just have the mentality of kicking ass when it needs to happen, you know, in the right way. I've got like a few quick fire questions, and then I've got a quick little thing before you go. So firstly, I noticed on your Instagram that, you know, I mean, first of all, you're gorgeous. But I see that you are well toned. Like, you do you go to the gym a lot? Like, do you work out?
I need to go to the gym, because when I walk up the stairs, it's a huff and a puff the whole way.
Me too.
I'm
quarantine fucked me up for that one.
I actually gained like 20 pounds through quarantine, so
I would not have thought that.
But I was really skinny, okay? I actually got a little, like, you know, a little bit thicker, a little more womanly, so I'm like grateful for that. But I definitely need to work out just for like performing purposes, because I haven't really performed this year other than, like, you know, pre-recorded like home things. So I definitely need to get into the gym. If I were to tell y'all in the gym, I'd be lying, and my makeup artist is right here, and
she's looking at you saying like, "Hey, you better be telling the truth,
like,
yeah,
don't you bitch, lie.
Don't you lie now, I'm seeing you."
Because she be working out, like, she be in, and she gets healthy and drinks water. I need to do all that, and unfortunately, I don't as much as I should. I like cheese, and I like to eat and then go to sleep. So I need to, though. But thank you for saying I'm toned. I think it's genetic, to be honest.
Well, I mean, you know, if you got genetics from your family, I mean, you know, going forward, like, your genetics, you know, to say your kids and your kids' kids, y'all straight, it seems like. So do you have an alien partner?
I do. I don't know if he thinks I'm an alien or not, but yeah.
Well, I mean, by association, if you're with your partner, then he's part of the alien family, so.
Yeah, he's still, like, he's, like, weird like me, like, in the sense of that, like, he, like, understands and, like, agrees with all, like, my weirdness. And we, like, send each other, like, you know, like, angel numbers back and forth, and we're both very spiritual as well, like, we meditate together, and. No, it's rather like weird stuff together. Yeah.
Well, guys, sorry, you know, she's off the market. She's with a fellow alien. So if you were wanting to apply, I mean, you're out the door, basically. Sorry, guys. You know, dream collaboration.
Dream collaboration. Oh my God, there's so many. But of course, like I said, I'm obviously obsessed with Frank Ocean. And Frank, if you ever see this, yes, I love you. We have matching outfits one day. Frank Ocean, for sure. Kendrick Lamar.
Ooh.
I also deeply love Kendrick Lamar, and I've actually met him and sat down with him and listened to my music at one point, wow, like 3 years ago. And
oh, wait, we can't override this. So what was the scenario? Like, what happened?
So I was in LA and we went to this TDE like opening for like some type of film they had. And after that, my manager at the time was good friends with one of their engineers, and he's a big engineer too, he's super dope. And he brought us like, you know, like, hey, do you want to be Kendrick? And I was like,
hello,
Lamar?
Girl, okay. you better go.
So we went to their studio and they're super cool. And he came in, he was super, super nice. And just like gave me so much like awesome like words of affirmations, like, you know, positive words. And he was just like, you know, keep going. Like, and as you grow, your music will be better and you'll continue to grow and grow and grow and grow. I was so fucking nervous. And
I mean, it's Kendrick Lamar. Hello. Like, you know,
he's like literally one of the people that I look up to. Like when I, and people ask me like career-wise or like creatively, like when you watch a Kendrick Lamar visual or listen to his music, you learn, you know what I'm saying? Like you're gaining something from that. When you listen to Frank Ocean, you're gaining something from that. At one point when you're listening to Kanye West, you were gaining something from listening, you know? And I love that. That's what I love. So meeting somebody that like, this is how I'm like modeling my career after, like, this is what I want to be. I want to be able to, people listen to my shit and learn something and gain something from it. And him like, you know, just being like, keep going. Like, even if you don't like your shit right now, you eventually will, as you grow as a person, like it's going to be, you know, just keep going at it. And he was dope. He was dope. He was really nice, like super cool, super nice. I was low-key like kind of drunk, so I don't remember all of it, but I remember being so like nervous that they were just like, relax. And like, he's like, it's just Kendrick. And I'm like, it's just Kendrick for who? For you, maybe? This is like one of my idols. Like, are you kidding me? So yeah, it was super dope. It was cool.
Well, I mean, big up yourself for meeting Kendrick and obviously get him giving those nuggets to you. And of course, like, you're on your way to, you know, superstardom. You know, you've got the look, you got the music, and obviously you got Nasty out there at the moment, which I was saying earlier, it's a really, really banging track. And of course, you got your upcoming project. What's your sign that's coming up in September?
September 2nd.
Yeah, so I mean, is that like an EP project or is it like a single project? What's that entailing?
So yeah, it's an EP, and there are 7 songs and a skit on there as well, and we have videos for every song. So it's gonna be
okay, fun. Sick. So you got like so it's like an audio and a visual EP, so to say then.
Yeah, it's like not all together,
but it's gonna be.
Right, and yeah, it has like a storyline, so there's like a significant visual aesthetic that people will definitely see. That's gonna be cool.
Awesome, man. And are you into astrology?
I am. That's like, honestly, I have an astrologist that I talk to. Her name is Lisa Stardust, and she's amazing.
Wow.
At Lisa Stardust on Instagram, and she does the astrology for like Teen Vogue, the O magazine, like freaking everything. And she's who I spoke to about the release dates for my project. So I kind of consult with her, and she goes through my birth chart and goes through like the planetary setup for the future. And she helped me pick the date. So when I dropped the single on August 18th, she helped me pick that date. And then she also helped me pick the date for the project, which is September 2nd. So everything is being dropped on dates given to me by my astrologist as well. So.
Wow, you go full in with this shit, man. You go full in. Okay, I respect that. Okay. So, I mean, obviously with, you know, your EP coming up, I mean, we've got a couple of months to the end of the year. What plans are you looking to at the moment?
I'm super excited for the project to drop. The music on this project is so amazing. I can really feel so confident and amazing that this is some great ass fucking music. So if anything else fucking fails, this is some good ass fucking music. So
I mean, really Nasty is on its way to that, because like I said, I'm banging it and it goes like that in my ears. Like bumpy. You know the ones there? You know the ones there?
But, I'm super excited. I had so much fun making this project with Spree, Wilson, and Jaron. And we just had a fucking blast. And I feel like you feel that through the music as well. So I'm just really excited for everybody to hear like how I'm developing as an artist, as well as the visuals. I haven't put up that many visuals in the past, so I think it's super cool just to, you know, have like a slew of visuals for everybody to be able to, you know, look at and kind of get to know me better. I'm also starting like a vlog. It's called Neila's World, and that's going to be coming a little after the project, but I definitely want people to get to know me better as well and kind of just step into my world a little bit.
Well, I'm happy to be in your world, you know, and go green, which I've already got to already. I've got a few more caps in green, so I'm definitely up for that, man. So, you know, I'm excited for the prospects. So before I let you go, I do this with all artists, but I'm a bit of a Twitter stalker.
Okay.
So I've seen a lot of tweets because you tweet a lot. So, you know, I just wanted to get through some tweets. They're a lot more recent anyway. And I just wanted to have some fun, get some more elaboration of what it means you mean, just for our audience to get a context of what you mean by the tweet. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, cool. All right, cool. So the first one I saw is, if you've blown out candles on your birthday and made a wish, you've done witchcraft. Okay.
Oh shit.
So what did you mean by that? Do you mean as in like, you know, it's a madness if you make a wish?
No, I don't think it's that. Like, and then under that tweet, I added like another tweet, and I like put that everything we were told was bad is actually bad.
Right.
That's what I asked for. I feel like. So background story. I was seeing a lot of things on Twitter. There's this company that has like, you know, feminine care, and on the company info, she talks about, you know, getting this idea from her ancestors and her using herbs and things to, her ancestor came to her in a dream and she got the idea from her ancestors. And people are like, oh my God, I want to support Black people, but they're so demonic. And I'm like, what about your ancestors is demonic? Like, where do we live that like your grandma coming to you in your dreams is demonic? Like, that's your ancestor. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I was just being an asshole, and I was just like, you know, literally, if you're 14 and you have 14 candles on your cake and you blow it out and make a wish, you're doing candle magic. So if you're like something demonic, like, you should think about blowing out candles on your birthday. Like, just being a dick. But yeah.
Oh God! Do you know what? Like, I mean, another trait with Capricorns is that, you know, we're the best assholes you'll ever meet.
Because it's true, like pagan wise, like there's like the pagan tradition of blowing out candles on your birthday.
Right. So,
but I don't think it's bad. You know what I'm saying? But it's just like, don't try to like call something demonic and then doing this, like not really knowing. You know. Yeah, I get mad on Twitter a lot.
Well, I mean, there's more, so we'll go through it. So lines are blurred way more than you actually realize. Not everything you've been told is bad is actually bad. So it's actually what you said in hindsight to what you said earlier. The next one is, my angles have been really chatty today.
Oh, did I say angles? I meant angels.
Oh, okay. Because I'm thinking angles as in like, what, when you did the selfies, were they talking to you or something?
That's really embarrassing. I definitely met angels.
Okay. So let's be clear. Let's be clear. Your angels. So in the context of this, so your angels have been really chatty. Okay. So what were they talking to you about?
I just was, that particular day, I was seeing like angel numbers like crazy. And usually when that happens, that just means something like big is happening, or I need to pay attention to what's going on around me. I'm very spiritual. So like, I talk to my ancestors. I go by astrology, numerology, all that kind of stuff. So when I see those type of synchronicities happening throughout the day, I know that something is something to pop off.
So. Okay. So definitely, like, you know, a deep conversation with the angels that look over you. Next one is Lil Booty got a lip bounce to it. On my tippy tippy toes when I'm on it. When I'm onto it, sorry.
Oh, so that's so nasty. Little booty got a little bounce to it.
Ah, okay. So you quoted it. I thought it might have been outside of the context of the song.
No, it's from the song.
Okay, cool. Extroverted around people who bring me peace.
Yeah, so I'm pretty to myself when I'm in like public places. I actually like despise being around other human beings.
Okay.
So
are you quite a socialite, or I wouldn't suggest that you're antisocial, but do you prefer like times to be social and then to be on by yourself? Like, how do you feel?
Yeah, I mean, I have a Leo moon, so I feel like I can be kind of moody.
Okay.
When it comes to being around people, I don't like being in a large group of people. It causes me anxiety and I feel uncomfortable, and I usually don't stay in like group settings often. So that's just talking about like, but that's talking about even like people in general, like people that make me feel safe and comfortable. I'm usually like really like, you know, rambunctious around them. But if I meet somebody for the first time and like their energy is off to me, I'm not going to talk very often.
I'm kind of like that as well. It's like, you know, if I've met you for the first time and it's like, unless like you give me the energies that I can work with you straight away, then I can give you my energies from the jump. But if I feel like your energy is slightly off, then I'm like, okay, I'm not going to put all myself in, because I'm thinking, is he holding himself back? I'm going to hold myself back too until there's a mutual ground that I can work with. So I'm kind of similar to that. I feel you. And I was actually looking into my sun, moon and rising just for fun. And I actually was checking out. Apparently, so I'm a Capricorn sun as normal, but apparently I'm a Pisces moon. And then I'm a Scorpio rising. Like, what does that say to you?
Pisces and Scorpio, I always say that like Pisces are two fishes because they're a little fishy. I feel like sometimes Pisces can be kind of like hot and cold.
Okay.
That maybe just from my, I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. I think it's just like, I just feel like sometimes they can be like, you know, little like you're not really sure sometimes. Like, I'm not really sure about some Pisces. Like, it's kind of like a mysteriousness about them. They're just like, are you my friend or are you not my friend? Do you like me? Do you not like me? I don't really know. Scorpio, I have a really good friend that's actually a Scorpio, son, and but rising is what you like present yourself to the world as. So my rising is a Libra, and that equates for like my loud, like, you know, I'm pay much attention, like a lot of attention to like my physical appearance. So rising goes off of like what you present the world as. Your moon is like who you are inside.
Okay. No, do you know what? Hearing that, like that pretty much sounds like me. Yeah, I take those things. So, yeah, like you should be a full-time astrologist.
That's like, they know a lot of knowledge and they know a lot of what shit means, and it took me a few years just to like figure out some shit about myself. So I big up to the astrologers because they be fucking knowing.
Well, they must be known in that respect then, for you to know all this knowledge that you put on yourself. Just a few more then. Life is so much easier when you don't take things personally.
So that's just something that I live by. There's a book that I read called The Four Agreements. And one of the four agreements is don't take things personally. So if I, like, for example, so if somebody came up to you, or someone, this will happen to everybody, when you're driving a car, right, and you're in traffic, someone cuts you off, we get upset, because, like, how fucking dare you cut me off? But it's really just, like, don't take it personally, like, they don't fucking know you, you don't know them, like, you know, just try to, like, because when you take things personally that are not meant to be, which, like, even, you know, if someone's like, oh my God, you're ugly, or someone's like, oh my God, you're beautiful, who fucking cares what they think? Because, like, what do you think about yourself? So don't take anything, good or bad, personally from anybody else, because you don't want to base off of what you feel about yourself or how you deal with things internally based off outside resources.
Wow, I definitely would take that on my board. Yep, I like that. I like that. I definitely like that. I was told that in a past life, I lived by the sea. It totally makes so much sense.
That's just literally what it, yeah, that's literally.
Do you feel like have you got like the mermaid mentality then? Like that you live by the sea?
I absolutely do not have a mermaid mentality, but being by the ocean makes me feel very calm. Like being in the water makes me feel very calm. Even when I have to think, I literally just go in the shower and think. Like I just sit there in the shower and think. So I listen to like water sounds to help me sleep and stuff like that. So water in general just makes me feel very calm. Like it eases me. I love when it rains outside. I love walking. I just like water and ocean. But I had an Akashic Records reading a month ago, and Akashic Records is kind of like the library of souls, basically. And each soul has like a book, and you can past and future, mostly past of a soul, and possibilities of the future, because the future is ever changing based off of our free will and decisions that we make. I was told that in the past life, in several lives, I was like a shamanic teacher, a healer, a witch, a spiritual person, a steward of the land. And in this particular life, I was like a witch and a steward of the land. I was taking care of the land, but I lived by the sea. And I'm like, that explains why I fucking love the ocean. Like, it gives me so much life.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, your photos that you take by the beach, I mean, there's certainly like, you definitely belong in the sea, especially what you're working with. Okay, then you're meant for the sea. You're seminal. last one. Sometimes I know exactly what this life is, and other times I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, but I learned that's okay. Either way it goes.
Yeah. I was probably having like an annoyed day that day, but literally like, it's like those days when, you know, like I usually know where I'm going most of the time, just like, you know, future wise, I'm a planner. So I usually know where I'm going, but there's some days you're just like, what the fuck? Like, especially the times where, with, you know, a couple months ago with everything going on within like the Black community, it was just, sometimes it just feels like, it felt for me for a moment like, why am I even trying if they're just gonna like knock us down anyways? So it was one of those things where it was kind of just like, you know, there's days where you feel like life is like knocking you down, but you learn from those, you know, chips, falls and tumbles as well. And you just gotta keep going. You learn from both. You learn from knowing where you're going, and you learn from trying to figure it out, so.
And last thing, because this is just coming to my head, as we were talking about earlier, like, you know, your weirdness and how you embrace your weirdness, what's the weirdest thing you have ever done?
Weirdest thing? I mean, I think weird is like perspective.
I mean, say to others, when they look at it thinking, nah, that's some shit. That's some bullshit.
Shit, Aaliyah, what's some weird shit that I've done?
I don't know.
I don't fucking know. Everyone around me is kind of weird. I mean, I'm pretty witchy.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Oh, and I'm always naked. Oh my god, yes. I'm always naked. I'm literally always naked. I'm literally, like, my team, minus my manager, because my manager's a man, but my team is pretty much all girls, and I really don't be giving a fuck, genuinely. And my boyfriend be like, bruh, you're naked? Like, really? But yeah.
It's like he must be thinking like, well, I mean, you're kind of ruining the mystery a little bit. Like, you know what I mean? If you're always naked, then, you know what I mean? He must appreciate it a lot, but like, damn, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it's not on Instagram or shit like that, but like, he'll come to like a photo shoot of mine, and we've been getting together merch for my project.
Right.
And like, we're doing, it's really cool. I don't want to like go into much into it. Like, the shoots I'm like naked in, and he's just like, oh, so you just, he's like, where's your outfit? Like, you got an outfit? I'm like, no, babe, like, we're gonna do this and this, this. So, like, you won't even realize. And he's like, okay. And I'm just like, free, just like, blah, blah, blah. Like, my makeup artist and my photographer is literally just used to it. And they're just like, okay. But.
I don't think I would have the same effect if I were to go on set naked. I think I would probably just be cussed at and say, put your fucking clothes back on.
Like, I'm ready for my PETA photo shoot. Like, I'm totally ready for my PETA photo shoot. So
for your PETA, what? Your for your PETA? What? PETA.
PETA? Yes.
Was it what's the PETA
they're
photo
like, shoot? They're like an animal rights
Oh, okay.
Like,
oh, okay, okay, yeah, okay.
So they do photo shoots where it's like you're like naked because, you know, like, if they're like against like fur clothing and animal produced clothing.
Right. So, right.
And,
okay.
Like, usually, like, the artists or the actors are like naked in the shoot.
Oh, okay.
Like, yeah.
Right. Okay. I hear you. Well, I mean, Neila, it's been an absolute pleasure. I mean, this is probably the longest time I've spent chatting with an artist, but you've been so much fun to chat with. I could be here all day long, all night long, shooting shit. But, you know, I feel like it's time, you know what I mean? I'll let you go. You know, I know you've got more famous shit to do, so I ain't going to hold you up much longer. Pleasure to have you on. If you can tell our audience where they can catch you on all the socials, the floor is yours, babe.
Thank you so much for having me. This is really, really fun. You can follow me on Instagram at Neila Official, N-E-I-L-A Official. You can follow my Twitter at I'm Neila, I-M-N-E-I-L-A. I'm Neila on Spotify, Apple Music. Make sure you go check out Nasty. Again, it's N-E-I-L-A. Thank you.
All right. So make sure you check out Nasty. It's out now. It's a banger. Obviously, you know, with her project coming out in September, you know, What's Your Sign, that's also coming out, so make sure you check the EP, that's on its way as well. Expect her to come to London when this COVID shit is over, so make sure you hear about her much more. I'm excited, man. I'm excited for the prospect. So, you know, thanks for chatting with me, man.
Thank you so much.
All right. This is Jay Billz, Media Spotlight UK, with the beautiful alien that is Neila, and we are out. Peace.